Hello everyone, today let us see a composition in the ragam Yamuna Kalyani. Yamuna Kalyani is a derivative ragam of the 65th melam, Mecha Kalyani or Kalyani. The arohanam and avarohanam of Yamuna Kalyani are
Sa-ri-ga-ma-pa-ma-ga-pa-da-ni-da-sa, Sa-ni-da-pa-ma-ga-ma-ri-sa.
You would have noticed that all the seven swaras come in both the Arohanam and Avarohanam of Yamuna Kalyani. So, it is a Sampurna Ragam. And also, it is a Vakra Ragam. The Vakra Prayoga, the zigzag Prayoga or Vakra Prayoga comes both in Arohanam and Avarohanam. In the Arohanam, it is Sarigamapamaga, that is one.
Padanida,
that is the second one.
Sarigamapamaga Padanida sa.
Arohanam. Now, Avarohanam.
Sanida Pamaga Mari. Maga Mari.
That is the Vakram name, Avarohanam. It is also a Bhashanga Ragam. It is a Ragam which has a foreign note. And the foreign note is the Suddha Madhyamam, the lower ma, which comes only in the Avarohanam along with the original ma. So it is like this.
Sanida Pama.
That is the original ma.
Gama.
Bhashanga Swaram, foreign note.
Risa Mama.
I hope you can understand the difference between the original ma and this foreign ma. Okay, so this ragam denotes rasam like Shringara rasam, beauty, bhakti rasam, devotion, shanta rasam, tranquility, etc. Some famous compositions in Yamuna Kalyani include
Bhavayami Gopala Balam
by Sri Annamacharya,
Krishnani Begane
by Vyasa Tirtha,
Maitrim Bhajata Akhila Hrujetrim
by Kanchi Paramacharya,
Narahari Deva Janardana Sri Ramachandra Kripalu Bhajamana
by Sri Tulasidas. And there are so many film songs based on Yamuna Kalyani. Some famous songs include
Sindhanai Sei Maname Kannan Vandhan Ange Kannan Vandhan Isai Ketal Vellai Pura Onru Nadiyil Aadum Poovanam Yamuna Yatrile Ira Kaatrile Katin Mori Meduvagata,
etc. Now let us come to the composition. This composition, Jambupate in the Ragam Yamuna Kalyani, set to Tisra Ekatalam, is one of the Pancha Bhuta Linga Kritis of Sri Muthuswami Dikshita. Now, Muthuswami Dikshita has composed various Kritis on all paramount kshetras, and among them are the five kshetras sanctified to Lord Shiva, where it is believed that Lord Shiva is esteemed as the manifestation of the panchabhutas or the five elements of nature. And Dikshitar has visited each of these places and dedicated songs to each of these lingas, panchabhuta lingas. I have already uploaded one of the panchabhuta linga kritis based on Vayu Lingam, Sri Kalahastisham, in my channel. You can access that video through the link in the description below. This song, Jambupate, is composed on Shiva as water, in which form he is worshipped at Thiruvaneka near Trichy. This sanctum of Shiva has water flowing from the river Kaveri, and it even floods the shrine during rainy season. And this song is steeped in fluid symbolism. The name of the ragam itself is Yamuna Kalyani, and Yamuna is also a name of a river. If you see the pace of the composition, you can feel the effect of the meandering of a river in it. Such is the brilliance of Sri Muthuswami Dikshitar. Coming to the meaning, Dikshitar requests Lord Shiva to give the nectar of bliss. He praises Lord Shiva as the one who is worshipped even by Brahma. and he's the one who is born in water, the one who quenches the fire, the sorrow of our heart, the one who is the Lord of rivers like Ganga, Sindhu, Kaveri and Yamuna too. Yamuna here is also the Raga Mudra of Yamuna Kalyani. He is also the Lord of Sri Akhilandeshwari, whose throat is like a conch. Conch which is of water origin. Again, he is worshipped by Parvati, who is the daughter of the mountains, and he resides in the forest surrounded by elephants, etc. These are the descriptions, and also the Sthala Puranam is also mentioned in the song. Now, let us go to the composition. The notation of the composition is given in the description below. You can download it.
Jambopade ma pahi nija nanda advita bodham de.
Anirvachaniya
ನಿರ್ವಿಕಲ್ಪಕ ಸಮಾಧಿ ನೀಷ್ಟ ಶಿವ ಕಲ್ಪಕ ತರೋ ನಿರ್ವಿಶೇಷ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ನಿರಜನ ಗುರು ಗುಹ ವಿಭೋಜಂ ಪತೆ ನಂದ ಅಮೃತ ಬೋಧಂ ದೇಹಿ ಜಂ ಭೂಪತೆ ಮಹಾಂ ಪಹೀ